Played nicely there for Bell, who was right up there. Peters too right in there. But now it falls for McCurry. And on the far side is Lorimer. In a lot of space now for Scotland. The man with the cannonball shot. And a great save by Shilton. Well, that was an extraordinary break there by Scotland. And if love goes on, although Shilton is applauding, England, I'm sure, would be applauding him.
I was surprised here that he took it with the side of his foot, which gave Shilton the chance to read it. He should have hit it with his instep. He tried to be careful and couldn't.
And the crowd are beginning to rise to them as well, all their supporters. Richard there by McCurry, giving England the free kick. Shannon. Ball. Nicely played sideways to Story. Back in again there, this time to Martin Chivers. Played for Ball again. And Clark, can he get through? Clark, is he through? No, the linesman on the far side is flagging. And as Clark went through, he obviously must have been in an offside position. So no goal for England. Now it's with Alan Ball. Good ball there from him. Oh, and a nice backheel now, Clark. No, and it's wide. Beautiful combination by England with Shannon and Clark combining superbly, and Clark missing a good chance.
It was a first-class through ball here from Ball. Really caught them out. A lovely backheel, and Clark takes just a little time, and in the end he's hurried there to screw his shot past the post. A lovely bit of combination there.
Story, Ball v Bremner, quite a collision between those little men in the middle of the field, and the Scot won it. And Ball working very hard indeed on Lorimer. So uncharacteristic of Bobby Moore, and being told to calm it by the referee.
In the end, of course, Bobby Moore found himself not being able to get through to the ball. It was on the other side, and he found himself struggling, tried to get that right foot through for the ball, and brought Lorimer down in one great heap.
Now it's with Ball. Bell. Story. Clark played on nicely for Colin Bell. And Bell surely pushed off that by number 8 McCurry. Free kick. Alan Ball to take it for England. And Bremner standing, I would have thought, 3 yards off the ball, and he's got to be 10. Being told to go back by the referee. The referee really has got to take a firm hand on this particular situation. And he's reached for a moment into his back pocket. He must make sure that defending walls are back 10 yards. There's Ball with the kick. And Chivers! Oh, what a magnificent save by Alistair Hunter. He'd never seen Wembley before until
today. Lovely free kick. There it is, coming in. Chivers rises, meets it well. He's going to his right, checks, up he goes with two hands and pushes over the top.
So Holton watching Chivers there, really quite a physical tussle there, pushing and shoving all the time. Ball now with this one, and on the far side, Martin Peters! Yes, that's for England! And Peters, who's had such a poor game so far, steals in as he does so often, and that's 1-0 for England.
Typical Spurs dead ball movement in a way, except it's Alan Ball hitting it. You can see how Chivers takes the man out of the way on the dummy. Peters comes in on the far post, completely lost, and makes no mistake from there. Whatever he does in the rest of the game, when he gets around the goal, Peters is devastated.
So now Ball, played along the touchline for Shannon. Delicate cross there, but Bell couldn't get to it because Johnson was there. Chivers hitting it first time! And Hunter got well behind that beautifully struck ball from Chivers.
That is the shot of a class player. As it dropped on the volley, and also it's the save of a very promising goalkeeper. He held onto that beautifully.
Johnston pushing at Shannon. It seems to me that we're getting an infringement now just about every 20 seconds. The game, at the moment, having no chance to get into a flowing rhythm. Story's long cross, Peters heading it down. And a free kick. This time to Scotland. put there by Hughes, and Bremner going after Emlyn Hughes as well.
Willie Morgan did so well there to stop him, because I think Billy Bremner was going to lose his head at that moment. There's no doubt about it, was a late tackle. Billy Bremner laid it off well, Hughes came right the way through, and we've seen so many of those tackles really today where the player goes knowing that he's either going to get the ball or he's going to carry on and get the man.
Hay is going to take it. Hit towards Colin Steen. Moore lost that one in the air, and McFarland lost it on the ground. Bremner with a shot. Chasing after it again, and Scotland get the corner, and that really is the sign now for the blue shirts to come forward. Only two are left behind as Bremner takes the corner again for Scotland. It's one they had to win, and it's a tremendous shot there by Dalglish against the English post. What a tremendous let-off, and now Ball taking it up for England, and away goes Shannon, but he's offside.
Well, that was a save of a world-class goalkeeper, and also a brilliant volley there with the left foot. Look, he's leaning the wrong way, he goes up with that right hand there and just gets it away. That's a wonderful sign for England's World Cup chances, to see a goalkeeper replacing Banks with that ability.